The reason I became an orthopedic surgeon, I was fascinated with anatomy and biology. I was a science major in college, and during college I began working with an orthopedic surgeon because of my interest in human anatomy. And once I began working with this orthopedic surgeon part-time on breaks or on times that I was able to work in his office, I knew this was a specialty for me. I'm a member and a fellow of the American Academy of Orthopedic Surgeons and a member of the American Association of Hip and Knee Surgeons, which is a select group of fellowship-trained specialists that have their own separate conference and their own separate training that we usually attend a meeting once a year in addition to our academy meeting. The mass majority of our patients come to us, fortunately not doing many other things prior. They haven't tried injections, they haven't tried medications or therapy. And the mass majority of patients can be treated sometimes forever and sometimes for a long time. They can postpone hip or knee replacement or arthroscopic intervention with injections or therapy or medications. If you do require surgery and you fail conservative treatment, we have an excellent team that can walk you through from a hospital staff and bring a lot of peace of mind to the patient by preoperative counseling, preoperative therapy occasionally, and the preoperative class at the hospital is very educational to tell patients about the hospital experience. And then our team at the office will help patients walk through the small hoops that they have to go through from preoperative lab work and preoperative clearances with their other physicians, sometimes just their medical doc and sometimes cardiologists or other specialists will need clearance and recommendations. And we have different people that are set up to specifically handle the different parts of the preoperative class for the patients. We encourage preoperative class because the patients that do attend the preoperative class seem to feel much more at ease during their hospital stay, know what to expect, and they also have a generalized idea if they want to go home with home therapy or they want to go to outpatient therapy or if they want to go to a rehab center for a week or two after surgery. With our hip replacements and knee replacements now, we are able to do it through muscle sparing approaches. A partial knee requires no muscle violation and a total knee requires much less, if at all, muscle violation. Allows for a quicker recovery. That in combination with the specific medications that we're giving from anesthesia as well as an intraoperative medication cocktail that we give in the knee and the hip that's a mixture of medications that allows for proper pain control. And when you give the medications locally, many times the patients will have the pain control, but they won't get the effects of the nausea and vomiting that if they took as much medication by mouth. Over the past 3 to 5 years, I've completely gotten rid of PCA pumps where patients require IV narcotic medications, and most patients can have their surgery and have excellent pain relief with just the medications from anesthesia, from the ones that we inject into the joint, as well as with oral pain medication. I meet every patient prior to surgery. We confirm with the consent that the patient's getting the correct joint replacement. We sign the limb and go over any last questions that they have. They meet with the anesthesiologist prior to surgery and go over any questions about blocks or different types of pain control regimens. And then postoperatively, both myself as well as Jared Carter, my physician assistant, who patients have previously met, will be rounding as well as their medical doctor or a medical doctor that's been selected for them. In the knee, we're doing custom cutting blocks where it's patient specific. So we're able to take a preoperative MRI and custom fit it for that patient where the blocks are made specifically for that patient's anatomy. And that can improve the operative time, it can improve the recovery, and improve the long-term outcome of a joint replacement. From a hip standpoint, new technology, the mass majority of hips are now uncemented, meaning we no longer use cement, it's titanium. We either use a ceramic ball or a metal ball that articulates with the plastic. The mass majority of patients are getting ceramic now. I think the practice is unique in the fact that we have separate subspecialty trained physicians. And although many of us do very similar bread and butter orthopedic surgeries, if there's anything specific that needs more detail from a specialist, obviously Dr. Murray, myself, or Dr. Drake or Metz can refer to within orthopedics to someone that may have more slight expertise in certain specific cases. So we're able to custom fit the care for each specific patient and problem. I think orthopedics is long-term plan is probably to have 5 to 8 physicians. I think that within the next few years, we're looking forward to having a foot and ankle presence. We currently do a lot of ankle fractures and foot fractures, but adding a foot and ankle fellowship trained specialist would be our next goal, physician-wise. Orthopedic surgery, luckily, has the ability of helping patients recover, and it's usually improving their quality of life. And for me, it's the perfect specialty because you're not dealing with life and death issues, and usually the problems that you're dealing are fixable problems.